Hey everybody, welcome back to Magic Orthodoxy. My name is David and this is a Magic Review. Hey, you like magic? Of course you do. Why else would you be here? You like magic tricks, I like magic tricks. What I want to do is help you buy magic tricks that you love. Because I remember, right? I remember I was there. You go through the magic catalog, you go through it, you find something that you think is awesome, and you place your money order, because that's how old I am. And the stuff would come in the mail, and you'd open it up, and you go, ah, this is totally not what I thought it was going to be. No buyer's remorse here at Magic Orthodoxy. I want you to spend your money well. The stuff you get in the mail, I want you to know exactly what you're getting every single time. I want you to spend your money on the things that you're going to love, and the things that you're gonna perform. I don't wanna see any more magic in drawers. You know, you work too hard for your money, all right? So let's not waste it. Let's buy things we love, okay? So if I'm helping you out in any way, do me a favor. Do me a favor, okay? hit subscribe. I wanna see that subscribe number go up. It's been going up kinda slow lately. And so I'm getting worried that I'm not being a resource for you guys. So I want to know that I'm helping you. So if I encourage you or help you out in any way, please just hit subscribe. That would really help me out a ton. Today we're going to look at room 66 from Magic Dream Paris. What is room 66? Room 66 at its core is a peak device. It is a magic utility, really. I mean, they're going to give you some tricks and some ideas alongside this, of course, but this is the same as if you had bought a Peak wallet, except it's not a wallet. It's not a wallet. This is a Peak device that fits on your key ring. This is a little key fob, the kind that has the little white writing space. So, you know, you have keys to the shed, right? Or you have keys to your safe. And so you write on there, this is for the shed. Right? Or this is for my locker. My locker number is 612. It's that kind of key fob. So what happens is you give the spectator a pen and they get the key fob and they can write anything they want. They can write a number, they can write a word, right? Anything they want. Or it can be a part of your routine. And then without you looking at it, you're going to wipe off, you, the magician, will wipe off the letters or the word, because it's a dry erase marker, right? You wipe it off. And then you're able to tell them exactly what they wrote. So right away, is it what I thought? I didn't know what to think because I didn't understand how a keychain was gonna work as a Peak device, right? I didn't understand. I was like, does it open? Are they writing on the inside? I had a lot of questions. So it was interesting. Interesting solution. Is it well made? It's not made any differently, really, than one of those little plastic key fobs. I mean, it really is what it is. It looks like what it is, feels like what it is. So if you ever held one of those little plastic key fobby things, that's what it is. All right, so what's the overall quality and production value of the video? It is almost an hour. It is 54 minutes. And you can download this in French or English. It's filmed a lot like the other Magic Dream Paris videos. You have two teachers, multiple camera angles, and no music. As far as what they're gonna teach you, you'll get an intro and some inspiration behind the effect. They'll talk about what's in the box, and they'll cover the basic principle, which is the peak. They'll talk about how to palm, and they're gonna go into lots of subtleties about how to get your peak naturally. They'll talk to you about cleaning up, and maybe even incorporating some instant stooging, especially the kind of trick where maybe you have a spectator write something down and then you turn to a second spectator and have them also look at what was written, but you have switched it out for a different word and you could do like a memory forget style trick. They'll talk to you about how you can use numbers or words and what you would do if maybe a number was upside down or you couldn't read it. They'll mention, of course, that this works in any language because really it's not limited by language. And then at the end, there is a master prediction bonus close-up version. This is the kind of trick where you had your prediction out in full view the entire time, and the routine comes to a head by you having said, hey, I had this prediction in view the whole time, and look, when I opened it up, it's the thing we talked about. Pocket space, I mean, it's very small. It's gonna fit in the palm of your hand. And depending on how you wear your keys, it might be no pocket space. I mean, I wear my keys on the outside, clipped to a belt loop. So this would be a way you could do an everyday carry, have a peak device with you wherever you go. How are the angles? Okay, so there is palming involved, okay? You do have to palm. This isn't a completely all together unit. There is palming, and depending on how you do the trick, there could be ditching. But the nice thing about the shape is it's small enough that it would even hide behind a single finger, right? So this is gonna be the easiest palm you've ever done. Can it be inspected? I mean, certainly beforehand, right? Certainly beforehand, because they're gonna take it and they're gonna write on it. So they're gonna feel like they had it the whole time. There wasn't a lot about what to do afterwards. Most of the time when they were teaching this, they would take the device back, show that it was blank because they had wiped off the ink, and they would just put it in their pocket. So there's an element to this, I think, that almost doesn't let you bring it back out because of the nature of the effect. I don't want to give too much away, but I think it would be hard to have it inspected after the trick was done. Practice-wise, it's very easy to work. I think this is easier to work than even some wallets, just because of how small it is, you know? Where a wallet is larger, and some of the gestures we make when we open the wallet back up, they're telegraphed because it's so big. This thing is so small that you can get your peak in your hands, and your hand covers so much of it, they'd never see it. Set up and reset, you're gonna carry it in its ready to go state on your keychain. And then to reset, you're just gonna clean it up and go from there. Positives, like I was saying, this is a peak device more than it is a one hit trick, right? So anything you're already doing now with a peak, you can do with this because you're not gonna be limited to any one idea. It's a great everyday carry, right? It doesn't need to be your wallet. It doesn't need to be anything else. It's nice and small. It fits in your keychain. Great for mentalists, right? And if you're already doing maybe a key bend or some other type of key trick, you got the key trick and this together. Now you got two tricks that you can carry with you wherever you go. Negatives for me was in the idea, okay? I don't really have a negative for the utility itself, but just the idea that why am I asking them to write it down and then I wipe it off? You know, what's the point? Why are they writing it down in the first place if I'm just gonna wipe it off? Because so often our explanation as to why they're writing it down is so that they don't change their mind, right? You say, I'm just gonna commit you to something, and they write it down. So this almost feels like a center tear where you burn the remains, okay? So in that trick, you'd give them a billet, they'd write something down, you do a center tear, you'd burn it so that you can't go back to it, right? So like inspectable, of course not, it's ash. So it's that same kind of feel, okay? This isn't the kind of peak where they write it down, you guess, and then you reveal, oh, look, this is more like they write it down and you erase it and then reveal, but the gimmick goes in your pocket. Is it worth your money? It is $38, 38 bucks. And like I said, you're getting the single key fob device, and they'll even include a Crayola washable marker. But don't take my word for it. Don't take my word for it. Please go out to forums, go out to places where there are written reviews from people that have purchased this, read those reviews and make sure this is gonna work for you. All right, that's everything I can say about Room 66 from Magic Dream Paris. I, of course, wanna thank Magic Dream Paris for allowing me to have this so that I can do the review for you. And if you wanna purchase it for yourself, I'll stick a link below in the description. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye. But wait, do you wanna learn more about the t-shirt I was wearing in today's video? Of course you do. That's from my Teespring store. If you scroll down into the description area, you can click any one of those t-shirt graphics. It'll take you out to Teespring and show you my Magic Orthodoxy apparel. That's right, I've got several different styles and colors and price points to choose from, including my King of Clubs Black Roses exclusive Daniel Schneider tee. If you appreciate what I do, that is a great way to support this channel. Thanks.